Well, hello everyone and welcome to the channel again. Let me just wait for the things to start and see that everything is working as it should. Because you know me. Well, usually I miss things and there it is, I believe. The stream is working. Perfect. Now, too dark, I think, right? Hi there. Hello, everybody. Hold on a second, and let me fix this thing, cause it's too. Is it the image too dark? Okay. Hi, everybody. Hi, Michael. Let me before we start. Hi, Austin. Well, that was last week. It was resubmitted again, and now everything should be okay. So let's hope for it to be released, maybe tomorrow, maybe Wednesday. Now it's everything is on Giant's site, but yeah. Ryder, as far as I can see on the website, yes. The thing is, there is no more information about it. Let me show you something very fast. I don't know if you can see hold on a second, and we'll be starting with this logistic nonsense in a few. Just hold on a second, and I'd like to show you something very, very fast. So the thing is, that's my display capture, but I'd like to, let me change that very fast for here. That'll be okay. And okay, so hold on a second. I'm gonna make this bigger, and I'm gonna put it up there, just on top of the logistics. Okay, so guys, for everyone who's asking and. Where am I? Epic. I'm from Barcelona, Spain. But I'm living in Central America. That's fine. Don't worry about the dislikes. I don't care about the dislikes. There is a lot of people that just get into the video just to dislike it. But, I mean, it's good. Opinions are free. And if you don't like it, I mean, I'm so sorry. I'll try to make it better next time. My intention is not to like to everyone, but to... make you enjoy whatever is happening on the stream, and it's sad if you don't like it, but again, I'll try to make it better next time. Okay, so the thing is, I was saying, a lot of questions about the TLX, a lot of questions about ModHub, about if it passed, if it's not passed, or whatever. The thing is that this is what I see when I go into the ModHub. Okay, I just go into my mods, and that's what I see. Okay, so let me make it like bigger. Okay, that's what I see. So I see the 20-foot gooseneck baling trailer, it's live. The 20-foot gooseneck trailer is live. The TLX 2020 series, it says console testing. And the one that was sneakily sent into the mod hub, the gooseneck tipper that it's also in the mod hub, it says testing completed. Now, if I go into the TLX 2020, it says here, live, your mod passed certification. So that's all I know. And then if I go to the gooseneck tipper, it says testing completed. We are currently testing your mod again. I believe this states for console testing, but I don't know. So that's the information that I have. It's the exact same information. If you see this screen, that is the exact same information that I'm updating on the website, on the page. So there is nothing else, no extra information, no hiding information behind. It's everything that Giant does. As soon as they do it, I communicate it. But I'm not waiting for anything. I'm just waiting for Giants. So now getting into business. I'm quite sure you've seen around this logo, 82's Logistics. And it came from an idea that, for example, we build the TLX to be versatile, to be like your farm truck. The farm truck that you are going to be using in your farm to farm. Meaning, it's going to help you to feed the cows, it's going to help you transporting water, it's going to help you unloading a combine, it's going to help you in a lot of points. It's a truck meant to be in your farm. Then there is a lot of people that has been saying, you've got competition, I like NMC's trucks better, they are nicer. And I couldn't agree more in the fact that I like Chevys, I like Fords, and I do like Dodge. I love them. I like fenders on the front wheels and on the back wheels. That's why I built them on the first time on the TLX. I like the off-road bumper options. And I built them, of course, in the TLX. I like the tow mirrors. I like the straw bars. I like the LED bars. These are all the options that you're going to have in the TLX. And you're going to have also in the last NMC trucks by NMC modding. And let me tell you something. NMC trucks are going to be on my farm because these are going to be awesome. People say about competition. There is a competition when there is a prize, when there is something to win. But I'm trying to win anything. I do what I do because I love it. I do what I do because I like the people enjoying it. I like to see your pictures. I like to see your videos. I like to see your comments. All the situations that you will place the TLX through. That's what I like. I am not trying to win anything. Therefore, no competition is stated anywhere. As much trucks as we have, as fun as the game it gets. So, I hope it closes the thing on the competition, not competition, difference, no difference. There is nothing from my side against NMC, and as you do, as everyone does actually, I am waiting for their trucks to be released. I am like you do. I mean, this is going to be awesome. On the small part of modding, you're going to have the TLX. Whenever you have to transport liquids, you're going to have the TLX. Whenever you have to do anything small on your farm, you're going to love the TLX. So, having said that, hopefully it's been... I'd like to excuse myself for the time that I took into that, but I've received like a lot of messages about even people asking me when the NMC trucks are going to be released. I don't know. I wish it will be tomorrow, but I don't know. I can't tell. The thing is, what I can speak about is what I do in 82 Square Studios. In this video, we are going to talk about 82's logistics principle or brand or something. And I'm going to state a big what if the truck does that? Because that's the principle that is behind logistics. What if you have to transport bales? What if you have to transport water? What if you have to transport a longer load? What if, what if, what if? There is a logistic behind every what if. And that's what I'm going to try to show you. So let's get to it. Hopefully it's gonna let me, because gaming loaded, and I don't know if it's gonna be there. It's loading now, so while in the meantime, the tipper trailer coming out for all platforms. Indeed, that is the objective. The TLS passed. Indeed, it did. Yes. Is it anyone part of 82 Square Studio? Is just you? That's me. These two hands. Two hands, one brain, and a lot of ideas. So yeah, it's just me. What else? While the game is loading, sorry. So the thing is, DJ is in the house. I just saw your magical hand acting on my behalf, and I do love it. Thank you, my friend. You know, it's very, very hard to control the chat, and actually, I'm a disaster controlling the chat. So, let's get to game ain't showing, right? I mean, there it is. There's the game. And I need to remove that thing from here. No, not this one. This one. And also this one. There you go. There's the game. Okay. I can't mention any further mod since I'm kind of busy with what we have here in my hands. So, that's a tipper. You're going to see it right now. And I'm gonna show you something extra, because that was my situation a while ago. This 40 feet, and I believe, let me see, yeah, I saw it already, so let's get to it. DJ Goheim is only on the chat. He told me that he will not be able to participate actively because he is working, but I do appreciate that having him here. Anyways, your presence here is just awesome. So really, really appreciate it. So here we are again. We've never been here before. This is the infamous Ravenport. So, and I was talking before about a big what if, because you have, for example, the 20 feet gooseneck trailer. I've seen a lot of you people like this one. A lot of people is using it, and I really, really love all the pictures that I see around. Then I took it, and as you can see here, it's still branded Lizard. That's gonna change, but that was kind of my I don't know how to say it. I needed to put my hand into the mod hub. Now I did it, so it's gonna change. It's gonna be branded 82's Logistics too. But anyways, that's a pretty neat, simple trailer, very functional. Couple of functions, couple of wheels, and that's it. Then we came up with this. That was indeed a game changer. It was the first time ever that you were able to transport things on a flatbed and also transport content. Ramps, everything, wheel selection, couple of extra things with the lights, and the baling transport feature that I name it Bail It. Pretty nice trailer. Then a lot of people was asking for these monster. Triple axle, huge, maybe too much, but you asked for it. Remember, it wasn't me, it was you. The thing is, still, there is a lot of what ifs. So in this case, what if I just need to transport something small? What if I need to transport something wider, or I don't know, still fixed, don't like it. Then where is my tipper? Here. There's my tipper. That's where the 82's Logistics idea was born. The thing is, this baby is awesome. DJ has been using it, breaking it. DJ has been using it a lot, and I love it. And in this case, again, let me lease it. No, not now. What am I going to change? The presets? No, I'm just going to lease it as is. Mod guards. You remember, guys, the last session we did, so we have mod guards on the back. or in both sides, because I like it. I don't know. Tension bells, we're going to active them. And the wheel setup, I really like this wheel combination. I'm just going to change the top on top to red, because it's more, well, it looks better in my opinion. I'm just going to lease it, and then that wouldn't be fair to use this one, so I'm going to return it. And of course I'm going to get my TLX. You see here I have the Skyrock. I have the TTHD. I have the pickup 2014. I have them all. So that's the base that you're going to start probably tomorrow. Tomorrow, please, Giants, allow the people to have it tomorrow. And I'm just going to jump into my preset. Just set it 4.2. The Nokians. I'm just going to go into the Nokians like that. I really like this combination, which I believe is awesome. It's awesome looking combination. So let's go for it. Who else like this color combination? Who likes it? The squad posted. What? Gran Hilbert posted about me. That's awesome. Okay. I really like this combination, so I'm gonna go for it. Okay, lease it. And then I'm just gonna go for the bed. You're gonna find the beds in miscellaneous, and you're gonna have the flatbed, the tippet trailer, the liquid trailer, the luggage, and the luggage trailer. So far, I'm just gonna pick up the flatbed with diamond plate. I'm just gonna set the working lights, and I'm gonna paint it gunmetal to match the color of my truck, or might be blaze orange. Yeah, love it. There we go. So we have the truck. I believe I don't have any sounds because I'm a disaster when it comes into sounds. Volume master, vehicle volume. I was gonna set an environment volume 60. I don't want the radio. There you go. Okay, so again, that's how I would test my game with the Xbox controller. Sorry guys, you know I'm a disaster. Before I start, let me pay attention to the... Hey, yeah, that's something... Oh, let me do that. That's something I quite don't understand. We have 544 beautiful souls watching the stream. Could you be so kind to leave a like? Please. It doesn't take anything to you. Just pick with your finger, with your mouse, with whatever. And to me, it is really, really important. Because it means what I do matters to you. So please, if you don't mind, leave a like on the video. And if you're not subscribed, remember to subscribe. Blah, blah. Sorry. So the thing is, this is a TLX. This is going to be in your farm soon enough. Hopefully tomorrow. That's how it sounds. I'm sure that everyone has listened to this already. So let me just go backwards to the bed. And then let me go to the trailer. So, the trailer has all the goodies that I place on my trailer. To me, these are standards. For an example, the working lights. And you might say, why you want them there? I don't know. You have them. You don't want to use them, don't use them, but I can't remove anything that to me is a standard of quality. Also, the decals. DJ was pointing yesterday that you can see them perfectly. Indeed. Indeed you can. You can read them. If you get close enough, you can read them. That's important to me too. Dynamic mud flaps. They move. The side lights. They illuminate the ground. Movable parts. They do move around. the lights. Everything is measured. Everything is well taken care of. And that's why it takes time. It takes time to mod. Because I do pay a lot of attention to the details. For example, in the TLX, the LED bar, that's the trailer, still the trailer. For example, the strobe bar can be moved because of you can place the tip bed on it. The LED bar can move, and small detail. This small wire that you see there, it's gonna move. It's gonna be compressing itself. It's a dynamic hose, actually. So hose. I don't know how it's called. Sorry, let me pay attention to the chat. 444 likes. I love you. I love you guys. Thank you. So now, since I believe you've seen how the covers work on the actually the tipper is 13 megabytes. Tiny. I believe it's, I don't know how many slots, but it's tiny. The TLX with all the beds, it's 27 megabytes. So it's awesome. It's tiny, but very detailed. So that's the intention. Not to consume a huge amount of slots. So I was saying, you've seen that in the game, the animations of the covers are like pop, pop. They appear, they disappear. They appear, they disappear. I don't like it. So I did that. So the it folds, it compresses the different parts of it into the front part. Okay? And I believe, even if I'm not mistaken, you see that it's rotating, right? No one sees that. But I do it. I do it because it matters. To me. It matters to me. Okay, so these small details are the ones that I like the most. So you can go and you can fill it. Oh, now you see that the wheels, the rear wheels, ain't touching the ground. Now they touch the ground. Adjustable, depending on the truck. So, I'm leaving this area because I cannot activate the animations in this area. So, there we are. You see, for example, these are the driving lights. But these are the turning signals. You see that they are different details. Small details. Quality details. Okay. So. That's a bulk trailer, right? You transport stuff with it. I believe I don't have anything, and if I do, no. Okay, let me be DJ bait. Let me. I don't know how many weight. Just 1,000. Selected silo is empty. Where? Well, anyways. Since I don't game, I don't play. I really don't know how to play, so my apologies. I'm just gonna fill it with the F11. So, oh, I know why I can't. Because I haven't selected the tipper. I believe it's because of that. No, it's because it just hates me. Game hates me. Because I don't play. Cheat silo. It should be that. I don't know. Okay, I'm just gonna fill the trailer like that. and they'll be coding. Okay, so now I was saying the animations, okay? So you have a tipper.
Hooray.
I just placed this silo in here, as you can see. The ground ain't even. It's a disaster. I don't play. So that's the animation where you can. The grain, pistons, everything moves. There you go. It's gonna be empty. I don't know if there is a way to fix that thing, this kind of flat there. I don't know if there is a way. If I found a way to make it more real, I'll do it. If I don't, then I'm sorry, it's the engine. It's gonna be empty soon enough. There you go. And that's the animation I want you to pay attention to. As soon as it goes down, one door, the other door, and the lock. Pretty awesome. Now, again, that's a tipper. It has 26 liters of capacity, 26,000, sorry, or 30 with the extension. And there it comes, the big what if. What if I am like that and I need to transport something? Okay? If I need to transport something, I would need another trailer, I would need to do something extra. But what if I can open my tipper and load it manually? For example, you can put the new Bobcat. I just downloaded, I haven't activated. But the new Bobcat, perfect for this trailer. Like 100% fitting on this trailer. Okay, another what if covered. But since the players have spoken, I don't play. You play. I mod, I create, I design, you use it. So here's the deal. I listen to you. Because, I think I should. The thing is, as someone has sneaked in here, I believe it was. Hold on, who was it? Because I saw someone mention. I don't know, there's 100,000 messages in here that I haven't read. Damn. Okay, I need to review them later because that's a disaster. Okay. I was saying, what if? And someone seen it in here. Someone has seen this. That's just a picture for me to identify the trailer. It's not the final looking in any ways. So, I want, there is artist Jack in the house, also, that's awesome. Big shout out to artist Jack. The thing is, and there is FS Club 2 in the house. Sassy is here, oh my god, everyone is here. Thank you guys for joining. You know, this is not my thing. I get a little bit nervous on the streaming, especially when you see my face. I know a lot of people love to show their faces. That's not my case. So, what I was saying, this is just a picture that I've set in there for just to find my thing in the store. But here it comes. The big what if list. That's, you saw it and you say, that's the lizard. No? Isn't it just like very similar to a lizard, right? couple of things here and there. I just saw an error right there that I need to fix. I'm gonna fix it live probably because it's not sent. But a lot of people would see a lizard. Some details that were not on the lizard. It says heavy duty 48 spread axle, and there is a hole in there. Lights, tension bells. Then we have the wheel brand, and here it starts the big what if. What if I won triple axles? Don't get scared. There's a lot of things that are hidden in the mod that I need to fix. I need to kind of address. Let me see if there is some errors popping. No, that's not my error. That's from Giant. So we're good. The thing is, that is one of the ifs coming from the community. What if you want a triple axle shorty trailer for heavy and short machinery transport? There you have it. But what if you want to change the wheels, the brand wheels? Go for it. Go back to the twin axle. Now, what if you want a pure baling trailer? What if you want the rams? There is something very quick I need to fix. Hold on, guys. You know me, I'm a disaster, and I do apologize for what I'm about to do, but I need it. When I saw a mistake, when I saw an error, I have to fix it. So, I can't fix it by myself and you watching the stream, or I can fix it showing what I do to you, like live modding. What do you want to do, guys? Do you want to do you want to see what I'm doing to fix whatever I'm doing, or do you prefer just to wait? Answers. You want to show it, you want to see it. Jordan Fleming, you're going to be kicked from there if you keep asking for moddings, for mod. Okay, so I believe it's unanimous. You want to see how the magic and where the magic happens. So be it. Again, apologize if I do something that you don't see or whatever. Hi, JR. Thank you. Not an artist. Mostly I break things and then try to kind of sort them out. But, okay, what was the problem? I know that my trailer, when it's set up like this, I've designed a bumper. I have designed a whole bumper to be in here, to appear just right here. And it's not showing. Why? Need to figure it out. So, let's get to the code and see why. I know that I've coded this part into the foldable section, meaning foldable for the rams. If I activate the foldable thing, the rams are there or not. That's the attachable section, animation, foldable. There we go. So, why is that? No, it's not in the foldable. What? Where do I place it? Oh, no, it's here. Tail options. Okay, if I set flat deck, it should say rear bumper visibility active true. So, when it says flat deck, now the bumper should be here. Hey, bumper, where are you? Let me try to find it. Where is my bumper? Control F, Control B, Control F. Sorry about that, guys. It was supposed to show you the mod. I'll show you the mod, but need to fix it. I don't want to show any mistake. So that's my rear bumper is sitting on an index 1191. If you remember, guys, in the Farmcom thing by the developer from Giants, he was talking about indexes. He was saying all the objects in the mod have a number. This is the number that he was talking about. Just a little bit of extra information for you. Let me go very fast again, and let me see what is broken. I broke something, and I need to fix it. So I have my trailer, and I have my trailer modules. Oh, I hide the extras. Awesome, brilliant, David. You are so brilliant that you hide your stuff. And then you got aggravated because you don't see it. There you go. Okay, let's continue with the showcase thing. sorry for the interruption. And let's get back to the business. There we go. So, as I was saying, the what if. Here is how it looks when there is no ramps. So there it comes, the big what if. But what if I need to put something else behind? You see the big bowl, the big rear hitch. It's not that big. It seems big, but it's not that big, actually. It's the size. And all the lights and all the goodies from a gooseneck trailer. But has anyone seen something called length? Let me zoom out. So, this is what we understand by logistics. Logistics understood on a way to fix or provide solutions to an issue. The coordination, the act of coordinate a solution for a given issue and or situation. We have 20 feet there. We have 30 feet there. We have 40 feet there, and we have 50. So, the thing is, that's massive. That is massive. Huge. And again, you can go and select the ramps. It's even longer. I saw an error there because I've missed to code some lights. You see this white reflection on the ground? Need to fix that, but I'm not worried about it. It's just on one side, so it's gonna be easy. So yeah, it's not actually 50 feet. 50 as a category, not 50 feet. 50 feet would be like insane. It's a code of the trailer. One of the things that you remember, I said details, right? I said details. So that's 50 GN, 50 gooseneck. And now it's 40 gooseneck, 30 gooseneck, GN, and finally 20. But what if, for some reason, I need to use that with a tractor? Again, what if I need it to be a bumper pull? What if I want it with side rails? And last but not least, what if I am a logging enthusiast? Let me show you in the game how this baby looks. Come on, I'll be bare. Shh, don't say big text. Don't say big text. Actually, it's not. But Can you listen to turbo? Hereby, the 50GN by 82's Logistics. Whatever you need to be transported. That's kind of a slogan, it's awesome. Wherever you need to be transported, we got your back. So, looks the same, feels the same, drives the same, but it's bigger. A lot of people ask for the poles. So, as soon as we attach it, same functions as usual. So we have the gooseneck alteration. It alters the center of gravity of the trailer, and also the Sorry, this thing is so big that I can't see it. There we go. Okay, we have the rear ramps animation. As usual, you've seen it already. And now, allow me to help you with your logging. So, That would be the not the end, but would I have planned for this trailer? It's a composition of a lot of what if I can set up my trailer as I want. Of course, tension belts, blah blah blah. The orientable working lights. They are gonna be there. So there is something that it's not scripted yet, but it's gonna be, of course, in there. Is the rear hitch. You're gonna be able to set up, like for example, this. Okay, you're gonna be able to set up a small bumper puller, and in front, a big gooseneck. So you are gonna be able to pull the bumper puller with the gooseneck, and behind the bumper puller another bumper puller, or behind the bumper puller one of the tipper beds, one of the TLX beds. You really don't need a 60 feet because you can have one, I don't know, 10 of the 50 feet, one attached one to the other. So in the end, you're going to be able to transport wherever you want just with these trailers. By the way, just right now in here, we are having a small earthquake. Small. So if I have to run for my life, just you got to excuse me. Hold on a second. Sorry guys, there is a little bit of tremor in here, so if I have to leave, no, sí, hay, ha temblado ahora mismo, entonces, cuidado con las niñas, vale, sorry, apologies for the interruption. So, let me pay attention to the chat very fast, okay. It's fine, you can room, you need to be there. So hold on. There is no release date for any mod. Exactly. Thank you, Sassy. It will be possible. Visual Moose Gaming. It's gonna be there's gonna be actually I can't show it just yet. Because sometimes when you show something new, you know, other people like it and put it there, and I mean, like your idea gets taken, and I prefer just to keep it as safe as possible right now. But it's going to be there. You're going to be able to roleplay and do a lot of crazy stuff with it. So, yeah. We can't add a winch. Can you turn on donations? To be honest, I tried to activate the super chat thing, and I don't know how to. So it might be the next one. If you want to donate, there is, I have the PayPal for donations. Let me put it there. PayPal.me. There you go. That's the donation link. I believe I type it properly, or I'm just an idiot. Oh, sorry. Okay, I keep doing that. Yeah, that's the link for show love and appreciation to my work. That'll be the link. Let me place it in the description because I believe it's not there, or I don't know if it's there or whatsoever. I don't know if it's there. Yeah, it's there. It's in the description. You have the donation link. So yeah, it's there. Just in case you want to show some extra love. Not needed, not requested. Just in case you want. It's at your will. And of course, it's appreciated a lot. Okay, let's go to the chat. FSC. There you go. Thank you. Okay, so which Gusnek Transportella, TLX is in testing. Sorry, it's waiting release. I show it at the beginning of the mod. What if I have a wide load? Not right now, but I'm gonna have you covered. I don't want to show it yet, but it's gonna be awesome. It's like a transformer. It's awesome. I mean, you're gonna love it. You're gonna love it. Joshua, don't worry. Donations are by mean donations. You want it? It's really, really appreciated. You can't. No worry, my mod will be coming anyways. They don't depend on your donations or on your purchases somewhere. No. So far. I mean, at some point, if that becomes something like really depending or time-consuming, I might need to think on some sort of way to support what I'm doing. So far, mod will be as they've been. Close Gooseneck trailer, we'll see. No mods, no requests for new mods, please. One question, Javen. Shoot it. The question, I mean. Not in this trailer, it won't fit the oversized load because it's not oversized. The sign in this one, when you said the 50 GN would be extra long load, but we'll see. The 22 feet exactly has the capacity, has the capability of holding herbicide and fertilizer. The TLX 2020 is based off here. Actually, I avoided any real reference. My purpose was to create something that is not based on, because I don't know. It means a lot to me to create something that it's not there already. So there is the option gauge that you will be able to choose between bumper pull. I just show it. Here you have the attacher type, bumper pull, or gooseneck. So based on your liking, based on your needs, based on whatever you want, the moon. This trailer will be sent maybe tomorrow to Giants. I don't know when it's gonna come out. I know when I'm sending it. Remember the graphic that I showed to you? Hold on. Let me bring up something very close into the screen. Or maybe not. Why I am so bad doing these things, like in real time. I've seen DJ, I've seen FS Club, I've seen the squad doing these things real in live, real fast, and it takes forever to me, damn. So let me go very fast in here. What do you want me to fix? What do you want me to fix on live stream? That'll be interesting. These are the kind of things that I like to. Guys, I don't know. I'm kind of new in here. I don't know if there is something in between people. My point, we are all grown up people. I am a modder. I do mods. FS Club, showcase them. DJ, showcase them. And both are helping me. Even Silver News was showcasing them. I hope Mr. Silipi will showcase them. I haven't contacted with them yet, but I wish I could contact them to be able to do some sort of premieres with them too. So what I need is exposure. And these YouTubers, these awesome YouTubers are helping me. We are all grown-up people, so I believe we're easy to understand each other, so. Blow for the TLX. Oh, yeah, sorry. I was going to show you something. Sorry. I got lost in the chat. I got lost in so many stuff. Damn. Where are the guidelines in here? Oh, I remember. They are not here. They are inside. Where are they? Here. So if I go to login. Okay. Again. I'm going to show you again. Where is it? Image? Display? Here. So I'm going to show you. No, it wasn't in display. I believe it was here. Ah, there. This is what I see. And this is what I know. Now, just like 10 seconds to pay attention to this. As a modder, this is everything I can see. I see my two trailers that are already live in here. You saw them here. By the way, thank you for nearly 400,000 downloads and an incredible 4.7 rating on both. That's just touching. Okay. Now, the next thing I see is TLX 2020 series. And it says console testing. And that's it. Do I know when Giants is going to finish testing it? No, I don't. Do I have a way to know it? No, I don't. Next thing. The Gooseneck Tipper trailer. Testing completed. That's all I know. What Giants is going to do next? Only Giants can tell. As a modder, this is everything I see. This is everything I know. Even if I go into the TLX 20 inside, it says that it's live and my mod passed certification. This was the part of the report that was requested to change. But here, now, right now, it says my mod passed certification. That's all I know. I know nothing else. Same with the tipper trailer. If I go in there, it says, testing completed. We are currently testing your mod again. That's all I know. Can I text someone to see what's going on? No, I can't. FS Club, can you text someone to know what's going on? No, he can't. DJ, can you text someone to tell you what's going on with the TLX? No, he can't. Only giants can tell us what's going on. So, hope it's clear. Put this aside. And I was going to show you this. I believe is this one. Yeah. Okay. There you go. So, for everyone to understand how the process works. Let me know when you saw it. There it goes. A mod can be new, then it goes to pending. If pending is a very quick check the giants do. If it fails, it's sent back to review. And from review, it's go back to pending. If the minimal thing that are tested automatically by the giant's internal thing is passed, it goes into testing. If it passes testing, then it goes into console testing. And if both passes, it goes to live. Again, this is all we know. There is nothing else. Just wait. Just waiting for them. As soon as they come back to me, I'll fix whatever needs to be fixed. But so far, they haven't come back to me. So, I was saying, the trailer. That was the purpose. That's the logistics things. Now, as a statement, as a reveal, I am working on the same concept that you've seen in the TLX. TLX is a modular concept. You buy one truck, you have multiple purposes. I am building a set of attachments to my Gooseneck series. Because you might be able to transport your skidster, your stuff, but for some reason you want to attach some hydraulics into it to be able to tip something, like side tipping, it's gonna be there. Or transport liquids, it's gonna be there. So, not now, no release dates, nothing, it's still on design phase. But there is going to be a set of attachments to the Gooseneck trailers. Really, yes, the trailer is coming to all platforms. No, I'm not a fan of the auto load. Everyone knows it, I'm not a fan. I did something to help people who likes auto load, but we'll see what happens. Now, let's review a little bit the trailer, and I would like to, sorry, something just get into my eye. Damn. That hurts. Okay, back. Yeah, the one on the screen is gonna be released. No, I'm not a fan of the Real Madrid because I like football. So I'm from Barcelona, and I followed Barcelona Football Club. Supreme Parker. Yeah, I saw you there. So, yes, the ramps are optional. Oh, everything you've seen is optional, configurable, and modular, and so ever. So, for example, if you go in here, it says tail. So, the tail allows me to pop, set up the ramps for 20 feet. Okay, or even if you are eager to have tires, you can set up the triaxle on a 20 feet with ramps and bumper pull. It's up to you. you'll be able to set up as long as you wish. A dumb truck that's modded after Mac would be very badass. Indeed, it would be, but still a Mac and license. The Rust option is not an option in consoles. Sadly, the option that makes it rusty, like this. So you saw that's my baby. I have an option where I can go and select the messed up body. This option is not, I can't make it work in consoles because it consumes a lot. It won't pass. Sorry. Oh, you said if this a gooseneck or a bumper pull. That's the idea. It is a gooseneck. Or it is a bumper pull. Gooseneck, bumper pull, whatever you need. What else? Can the ranchero have a dumb bed? Indeed. Can I show the wear dead on the truck? On which one? The TLX? The Flegel was rejected by Giants because of the brand, and I was not in the mood of rebranding everything. Basically. The size that you're gonna have is exactly this one. If you set up this trailer as the 50GN with RAMs, the size is exactly the same. That's huge. Triple wheels, 50GN and RAMs. That's huge. Canadian Farmer, the TLX. Yeah, sure. I believe. I have one there. Yeah, here. Okay, so I have something in my eye and it's just bothering me a lot. Okay, so let me remove the HUD from here. And so for example, let's say 0.1 dirt. It starts to show a little bit of dust. It's more dust than actually dirt. You see a bit on the windows and of course bumpers and such, a little bit on the wheels, but it's just dust. So if we go 0.2, the dust becomes a little bit harder, a little bit stronger, and it starts to accumulate on the cavities. If you see on top of the hood, it's starting to accumulate there. That is below the bars on top of the deck, just right there in the cavities mostly. The tipper, the gooseneck is also getting dirty. Okay. And now let me remove all the dirt and just go by, I don't know, half dirt on it. So it's harder, wider, more spread, a lot of dirt to clean with the carter. And now I'm gonna remove that and go to the top, to the highest value of dirt. That would be this, and that's just nasty. It's very, very dirty. So you've been a bad boy with it, or bad girl, by any means. But yeah, that's full dirt on it. Now I believe I can show you too in here how the wear affects the paint and everything. So you see that 0.3, it's very light wear, a little bit of paint chipping on the front. Let me move it slower because I believe the stream is not showing it properly. I don't know when it's going to be, sorry Kenny, I don't know when it's going to be released. I know when it's going to be sent. It's going to be sent to Giants tomorrow or on Wednesday. That's when I'm going to send it. I don't know. Yeah, I can. There it is. Okay, so a little bit of chipping here and there. I try to represent like a small small rocks hitting beep 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 hitting the paint. And if you go like full wear, you being a bad farmer and you don't take care of your truck. Remember what I say. You don't take care of your truck, you being bad, and you basically messed it up a lot. You break it. Chipping, a lot of paint missing, plastic of course does not get wear, trailer is also messed up, and I'm telling you, it is very hard to get to this point. It's very hard to make it wear like that. Very, very hard. Takes a lot of time. Usually, the wear you're gonna see is just maybe like that, 0.3 or 0.4, oh. Need to go 0. Maybe, yeah, maybe something like that. No, it's too light. Maybe 0.5. Yeah, and that's better. That's the typical wear you're gonna be showing in your or seeing in the truck. Like the doors, the angles are chipping, the door angles and such. A little bit on the roof, a little bit on the angles of the flatbed you see in here. Because of the load, you load in there, so you chip it. Same on the trailer. Trailer paint is also getting like scratches and such. Also in the back. So yeah, I mean it has a lot of details. What else? What else do we have there? Mr. and Mrs. Engineer, I really appreciate it, and I just did it just for you. Just press the animation just for you because you appreciate it. So there you go again. There you go. But I don't know if you've seen what happened. Sorry, I'm just gonna leave the bedding there, attach the trailer because you can. You just leave it as is. It stays attached. So. Now that you see or you said that you like logging, allow me to buy the log bed and the log trailer, the small trailer. These are the small poles. This is a custom. I don't know if this thing ever exists. So, Mr. and Mrs. Engineer, take a look at that. There you go. The lock poles hide perfectly in the bed. So you have a flat bed, not able to carry all the bun pallets and stuff, but still multi-purpose. There you go. And what about the trailer? Same thing. Poles fold and unfold. You can place the logs in there. You can carry them around. What else? Nice stuff. I like when the people think. Love it. What's the length between the poles? I don't have a clue. I'm not that... I don't have a clue. I just place them, I don't know, just to for them to look nice and combine properly. Let me check. The idea of all my mods is for all of them to be released in all platforms. So that would be like the answer for this question whatsoever. All platforms are intended to receive my mods. So the idea of the log poles was for them to match like that. Okay, you see? They are one next to the other. The front one disappears with the animation. I don't know if you've seen it. But the front one appears only when it's unfolded. I don't know. I believe it's the nicest and cleanest way to do it. But yeah, I don't have a clue how many time. TLX is in testing for all platforms. No, that is wrong. TLS passed testing, and I hope so. It's going to be released soon. Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Engineer, for your kindness. Well, I'm not amazing, Tyler. I really appreciate the compliment. I just do my best. Valkyrie Gaming. The idea is to release it for all platforms. All my mods, unless I stated so, are meant to be released in all platforms. All of them. So, have you had ideas for a sprayer trailer? Luke, I might have you covered. Who knows? Sprayer of what? If it's manure, yes, I do have your back. If it is fertilizer or lime, not yet, but will. What else? What else we have there? Now I'm paying attention to the chat, so. The rancher will have dually option, of course. What else? Thank you, Joseph. It's been a nice day, even if it's a Monday, and I have a problem in the house. We nearly flooded the whole thing, but yeah. I do have an idea for a semi. I don't have more hands. Does the tanker on the TLX carry fuel? Indeed, all liquids. A full-size sprayer on the trailer. Don't know what you mean by that, but there is a sprayer on the trailer. What is the Lizard 1000? Thank you, Nathan. A long vehicle sighing at a longer version of the trailer. That is actually a very nice idea. Would it be cool if it's only available on the version without ramps? Because the one with the ramps, I don't know where you put it. Usually on the back, but where? Just folding there or holding there or how? Have I thought of a small tipper tender for the TLX for taking bulk seed and fur to the field for filling cedar? I got your back. You'll be able to do that. Thank you, Curious Farmer. I appreciate it. A four-wheeler. Not in the plans, to be honest. A lot of people asking for it, but not in the... To be honest, not on my schedule. The rancher is going to be compatible with all these beds plus some other goodies. A beacon under the ramp. What? Where? Hold on, guys. Hold on a second. I don't want to reveal anything about the ranchero. Please respect it. The TLX passed indeed, as far as I know. I don't know if there is going to be a comeback from Giants. As far as I know, it passed. Semi-truck, not right now. There is no plow attachment for the TLX. No, there is not. That's version 1, and I need to cut it somewhere. I mean, if I keep adding stuff to the TLX, you would never have it. So I decided, okay, that's enough. Cut it here, and then work on something else. Hold on. Sorry, live calling to the door. Hold on. Yeah, but it's possible to release tomorrow the TLX. Who knows? Only Giants know that stuff. Progress on the other tracks is progressing properly. I don't want to give details on that, sorry. For the two versions, can we have a truck bed? What? I showed a plow on my last stream. Yes, indeed. A model of a plow. It needs to be, like, built. Bowener making a travel trailer. Not right now. You're making different versions of the TLX? Yes, I do. A little. Okay, I was talking about the trailer and I was really interested on how to improve it. Oh! We just hit 600 likes! Damn, love you guys, really, really appreciate it, I really appreciate it. Thank you, FS Club, you know I missed the things in the chat. Ah, sorry. Indeed, the purpose and the principle of my mod is gonna be the same. You're gonna have the Ranchero with a set of beds, all the beds on the TLX compatible. Not so far, I'm not gonna be doing a semi. You can ask that 100 times, not gonna happen right now. Hi, Tiny. The Ranchero is on the design table, so I really don't know. The Ranchero coming to PS4, I don't know. I hope so. Okay, what else? Mr. and Mrs. Engineer, you were talking about the trailer and I do appreciate it, you paying attention to the trailer, which was the purpose of the stream. You said something about strobes on the bed. Strobes where? I really appreciate it. Morrison Man, a new follower, I'd say, because you don't know where the Ranchero is. I really recommend you to go back some streams ago and check for it. It's gonna be amazing for you. Hi, Midnight. Here, spending some time with the people. If I want, I could. Yeah, of course. I'm missing Mr. and Mrs. My phone is just driving me nuts. It's just... Okay. Yeah, we can have a TLX that transforms into a pile of crap and then jumps and sings whatsoever. Yeah, it's crazy. Could be on the hitch arm. Nope, not now. Okay, strobe. Maybe between the ramp bar as it's folded up. I'm not gonna put the strobe bar in there. You really wanna put the strobe bar here? In between these two nice lights? Ha, why? Why would you then? Ron Gindele. If you ask again for another mod, I'll kick you. I don't like it. But stop it. So, there is no room for that. Hi, CW. Doing good, thank you. Under the fold part of the ramp. Hi, Sam. Side strobe will look okay. Side strobes like in here. Let's do something. No, I can't put tension belts on the ramps, because you can open them, and if you put something on the ramp, you tension it, and then you try to open, the game crashes. So, can't happen. Okay, let's do something. Live modding. Welcome to a session. You said strobes. I'm not a fan of strobes, actually. I built a bar because I like it, but I really don't know where would you put a strobe in here. But let's go for it. Let's try it. Let's try to see where would you like them. And I'll code that as an option. An option. If you don't like it, you don't activate them. Okay, so I'm gonna put this in here. That's a transform. I need to drag this here and somewhere around here, and then I'm gonna use Giant's assets to make sure everything fits the standard in consoles. So where are my beacons? Where are the beacons? Where are the here. Okay, so that'll be beacon light 01, and now you want me to leave it? You said you were the one who said this, the thing of the beacons. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna do this very fast to see just to see how it looks. Oh, shoot! Don't do that. There you go. You like the mod flaps, thank you. There's gonna be a set of tools to be configured on this trailer. Not now, but in the near future. Like the TLX. So, you wanna put a beacon in here? For real? That's what you would put a beacon? Well, thank you anyway, Kenny, for your time in here, and do appreciate your time. Thank you. Okay, guys, beacons on the ramps. You like the trailer the way it is? I do like the trailer, indeed. But there were people asking for the beacons, and I don't know, actually, I never seen these trailers in real life. I've never seen this trailer in this kind of trailers in real life. We don't have them here. Just imagine, and I really don't know where a beacon would be placed. Between the work lights, you wanna put. You want this beacon? Well, actually, this beacon is awful. I believe the one suits better could be this one. That's horrible. What is this one? Ew. Sorry, Giants, mean no offense, but there are some beacons here that are just horrible. I believe the 6 is the one I like, yeah, it is. And the 7. Oh, who knows? So the thing is, My favorite mod so far, I have to say it's a TLX, but it's not. My favorite mod so far is my beloved K30 from 1979. So... okay, so beacons or no beacons? Now is the time to talk. Beacons or no beacons and where? There must be an agreement because I can't place them everywhere. I don't know when the stream is going to end. I don't know how. We started 85 minutes ago. I said it was going to be 30 minutes and look where we are. So yeah, I don't know. No beacon. Beacon, no beacon. Beacon, no. That's not an agreement, guys. No beacon, no beacon, no beacon. Okay. For the people who says yes to the beacons, where? Yeah, Curtis, that's not possible on Xbox, I'm afraid. Under the support bar for the bottom of the ramps. Under the support bar of the bottoms of the ramps. So, they would be placed like that. They would be placed like that. You don't see... oh, shoot. You see? Made mistakes. Damn, you were supposed to... you were supposed to be watching what I'm doing. There you go. Sorry, guys. You could tell it. Apologies for that. You know I'm a disaster with the stream. I'm so sorry. Okay. Well, now you saw it. The lead strip, it's on the TLX, on the T-pit, and there's a lot of lead strobes in there. So, LED thing, not an option right now. So, you said this would go somewhere around here? Like, in there? If there is beacons, there is going to be optional, no mandatory, that's for sure. There is already a hitch. So, how many people just joined? Because there is a lot of things that we've already showcased. Brian B, great idea. What's Brian's idea? Yeah, I know, Callum. The thing is that streaming cameras and microphones is not really my stuff. I used to play with other people, but not to stream and communicate. So, starting on to do it. So, apologies. It'll be better. It'll get better. That's a promise. No, these are not the only two beacons. There are actually three beacons in here. These are not the only ones you can use, but the best ones. Like the nice looking ones. The other ones are like awful. Hull Brothers Racing. There is already a hitch there. You wanna saw it? You wanna see it? Hold on. So whenever you choose this option, is it showing or not? Damn, I know, yeah, it's showing. Yeah, here it is. So, whenever you choose this option with no ramps, there is the rear bumper and the rear hitch, plus extra light and stuff. So yeah, there is a rear hitch for you. Curtis, there is no toolbox. There will be a set of winter tools for the TLX, indeed. The beacons on the bottom under the ramps. I must be an idiot or such, because if you put the ramps on, there is no rear hitch. Because where to put it? There is all the hinge system and such stuff. Besides, if you attach something and you open the ramps, it's gonna collide and it's gonna be a disaster. No. Not possible. No, there is no service bed. Under the frame. Like, inside the ramp or just below, in here. Everybody loves everybody. I like that sentence. There is an upshell for triaxle. Yes, Mr. Mrs. Engineer. Bumper pull option, of course, Ryan. I really, really recommend you start the stream from the beginning, because you miss a lot if you're just joining. So, let's do a quick recap on what we've seen so ever. That's basically a trailer. But what if I want three axles? And what if I want ramps? And what if I want it longer? Or even longer? Or even longer? But still, what if I want it with side rails? With lock poles? Or a bumper pull. What if I want a shorter bumper pull with lock poles? And I want a tiny little beast thing for the woods. I don't know, it's up to you. Barry McKuniger, you haven't seen 30 seconds ago where you have these. You could set up as long as you can, as your wishes. Flashing light bar with orange and white, there's small that city trucks have. Well, since that is a trailer, I don't see it fitting it. Yeah, it all started there for you. But on my mind, I was very far away from that. Well, even if you want that crazy thing, you can always attach 50 feet gooseneck and 50 feet bumper pull. So yeah. Tanker attachment is already there. Not going to be released right now because it's a part of other goodies that are going to be released for my trailer series. But you're gonna have it there. Oh, I'm pretty sure DJ is going to use the 50 plus the 50 plus the 50 and it's going to make it fly. That's for sure. It is for all platforms. AG Booher, thank you. I appreciate it, Timberwolf. And Timberwolf Login, have you seen the poles? That's for you. Folding and unfoldable poles. For luck, for being huge. Looks. On each side of the ramp. You know what? I'm just gonna experiment a bit with the... Let's do something. Since I'm listening to you guys, let's do this. I'm just gonna keep the small one. So the small one would be the beacon 6. Okay, so the beacon 6 is gonna be centered in here, and I'm gonna just make a quick test. I hate when it trembles. Fuck. Oh, sorry. Sorry, YouTube. My bad. You know I didn't mean it. No, thank you. Thank you. Thanks to you, Joseph. I know it's late there, and thank you for being here. I really, really appreciate it. So that's going to be the beacon. Whoa, no. So a tiny beacon. Tiny, tiny little thing. I don't know. Somewhere around here. Okay, let's do this. That's beacon 06, and that's going to be, that's going to be called beacon 06. Let's see if it allows me to dynamically load it in the game for you to see it. So that'll be beacon 06. That'll be beacon R. That's now there's people who do who does speed run. I do speed modding. New creation by 82 Studios. Speed modding. Oh gosh. What else is there? Okay, I need to change that and this. I need to go in here, desktop. I need to explore my things. Open a file. Defeat modeler, trailer. Control B, Control S. And now we need to go into the light section. We don't have beacons in here, but we can have them. Since you see here, FS19 TLX Ranchero. Ah, you want me to go in there, right? Not gonna happen. Sorry. This one does not have beacons. Where do I have my beacons? Oh, here in the TLX, I have beacons. Bye, X-Pro. Thank you for joining. I appreciate it. And it's not gonna be there. Where do I have them now? Sorry, just a second. And I don't know if Giants is going, if the game is gonna allow me to dynamically load in the game beacons without leaving the game. I don't know that. So we'll see. So that's assets. Oh, I hate you. Let's see if it works. Do we have beacons flying around? No, 101175. It's not loading it. I don't know why. There is that mosquito in my room. Get out of here. It says it's not there, but it should be there. I believe it's not able to load it dynamically. No. Count 00175. I might mess up something. Hold on a second. I'll be back very fast. When I'm modding, I'm not paying attention to the chat. I hope you understand. It's gonna be loading again. Tipper trailer in testing. Tipper trailer completed testing. When the TLX comes and DJ goes crazy on farm team news. The TLX has been taken. The Martians came from Mars, and they love it so much that they took it. They took it with them. Stolen. No, I don't know. Hopefully tomorrow. Is there going to be lights on the bumper pool? Of course. There is lights everywhere. Let's see if Giants likes me better this way. Somehow Giants does not like me. Because I'm... Oh, there they are. Tiny beacons. Awesome. How lovely. Okay. Let's see if it works. Nobody knows. Nobody knows. Just Billy H. There we go. Small beacons. They don't move, of course, because I haven't scripted them in the right place. But they have beacons. You really need this thing in there. Is there a reason the trailer unloads so slowly? The unload speed is as is, should be realistic. So, beacons there, yes or no? This truck is awesome, I know, that's my baby. That's my thing. Okay. Oh, you don't want beacons? How about performance wheels on the TLX on the trailer? Ryan, remove the capital letters. Remove them or you'll be kicked or silence or I don't know whatsoever. Beacons are there, an option. Okay, an option for the beacons. Yeah, might be. So you like this truck? that's my beastie. That's PC exclusive. That's crazy polygon. We are here for the 82's logistic brand. Let me disconnect the damn beacons. Okay, no. May I recreate my baby? It's just there. Why I would recreate it? It's just right there. Look, nice and easy. No, in consoles it would be impossible. Optional. Well, we'll see what I decide about the beacons. Hey Sam, I appreciate it. Oh, you stop texting. Yeah. There you go. Sam is there. 29 likes for the 700 likes, and I believe it would be my best rating. I don't know. But the thing is that, okay, loan care option. Put this upon the community person immediately after the stream. So are you giving me an order? Is that how I read it? Should I do it immediately? Will you please show the work lights on both? Work lights, you mean on the trailer? Two bars on the back side. Hi, Quincy. I know. I was just kidding. Messing with you, Crenshaw. I got it. Might be an option, actually. The bumper pool does not have working lights because there is no place to put them, actually. I might think of something, but so far, not working on that. Let me go into the night and I'll allow you to see how it looks in the night. Where is it? Day here. So let's go 2 a.m. in the morning. So it's like that. So whenever you, well, in this trailer I ain't scripted yet because I need to, oh yeah, they rotate, awesome. But the light does not rotate because it's scripted on the wrong node. So again, let me fix it. Oh, it's trembling again, damn it. It's creepy when it trembles. Close your utility saturator, not now. Hold on, let me fix that on this animation because it's pointing to the wrong node and the lights were not turning. You see all these green things in here? I mean, it's, there's a lot of work to do. Work light L, work light R, and then on the cylindered section, rams, this one, working light L. Now, one of the other things I need to move is this. These babies should be inside the ramps. So whenever I extend the ramps, they will move with the ramps. So let me save this one. I believe Giants is gonna like, it's gonna allow me to do what I did, because the everything was already there. I haven't added. So the thing is, you were asking to see how the lights work in the night. So, okay, let's go to the flood deck. The beacons are there. No, there you see. Damn Giants, you don't like me. I need to leave the game and get in. Okay, I'm not going to say anything about what I think you should put on any other mod. I think you should put on this. No. I mean, Crenshaw, I know. But I really like to have feedback. It's not just making something and then you give it you to eat it. I mean, how would you feel if you see that there is something missing on the trailer and then you tell me and I decide that it's worth the effort and I put it there. So when you're gonna use it, you're gonna use it as I imagined. But you're gonna have that special feature that you like and it was missing and it was worth adding. So that's what I like. Seven-handed likes and yeah, I'll probably call in the another stream. So there are the beacons, there are the lights. The lights are gonna be messed up because now they are turning upside down. I need to work on that light, sorry. But the thing is, 701 likes. Guys, you are just amazing. You are just amazing. We have 385 people, soldiers, because that's been a long, it's 108 minutes so far. Resisting here. So really, thank you. Thank you for being here. So these are the strobes, and oh, and now they move with the ramp, which I kind of like it, to be honest. I might leave them there. Like it. I need to fix the lights because now they are turning the other way around. Sorry, that's live modding, guys. Okay, 750 likes. I would love. Hey, FS Club, I need to talk to you because yes, indeed, the 40 feet is coming to everywhere. It's gonna have, you're gonna go and eat a sandwich, and you're gonna have the 40 features next to it. It's gonna be everywhere. So yeah, I'd say so. Yeah, the beacons came out really good. Thank you, Joshua, for your time being here. Oversized load signs with the flags for the trailers. I might analyze it since it will add some extra details. Jesse de la Garza. Bueno, si lo digo en español es mejor. Jesse de la Garza. So not now, because you're gonna have the tipper that allows you to put something. Sometimes it's better to show you rather than explain it, because explaining it, it's not my thing. So okay, you're gonna have soon enough this tipper released. So the tipper is gonna have this animation that allows you to, well, open it, and then it's gonna have this other animation. Okay, so I know it's not an enclosed trailer, I know, I'm fully aware of that, but still, you can then go to your Skidster, go to your Massey Skidster. I love this thing. That the work that that done by Black Sheep Modding on this one is just awesome. And then you can go into your trailer. Remember, I don't play, so I'm very bad. And then you can load your Skidster just right there. So that's the thing. This trailer is my baby. It ain't coming to Mod Hub. Actually, I'm just gonna drop it down there. Bye. And I'm gonna get the TLX. Now you can answer, is this coming to all platforms? Indeed. You know, one time that you were going to try and get one of your old fours on console. Not a Ford, but who knows? Who knows? Yeah, that's the price. Yeah, loading that thing with pallets is gonna be funny. It's gonna be, yeah. Okay, what else we have here? We have 715 likes and 10 dislikes. The people who dislike the stream, I would love to know why. Because I would change it. I would improve it. It's just so unpersonal. And if I do something that you don't like and I don't know it, it's kind of... Can you buy the bumper pool so we can see it? Of course, bumper pool. Yeah. Bumper pool. Where is it? Here. So... okay, let's configure one of those. So you wanted bumper pool. No, that's the ramps. Bumper pool. What else? Do a live configuration of that. Bumper pool and... What else? It's 723 likes. That's just amazing. That's just amazing. Yes, Ryan, the sound of the Chevy is possible on consoles. Indeed. Triaxle. Okay, let's go for triaxle. What about the length? The length of it. Ramps. Okay, ramps. There we go. Triaxle and ramps. What about 30 feet? There you go, 30. No, I can't add a winch. 30, 40, 50. Damn, you like things big. Let's do something. Let's do something very fast. Okay, we're gonna do that. We're gonna do that. That. And that. So. There you have it. It looks like... Oh, fucks. Papa! Sorry. Warning flex. Kinda don't like it. Four-door long bed TLX. No, I don't. 732 likes, guys. That's just amazing. That's just incredible. You really like it. And that's my... I was talking at the beginning of the stream about competition and about prices. What? Shut up. There is no competition going on. But you guys and your support, your appreciation, that's my price. That's what I like. With standard pick of bed, I don't know. Might consider it since it's gonna be since it's been requested all over. So might consider it actually. So there you go, guys. And now the question. Do you need more trailers? Jason is going to be reliable, of course. Breaker TV, appreciate it. I really appreciate your kindness. So you want more trailers? For what? Oh, a box trailer. Wow. What is a Yugo? Campers for console. Hold on for that. Can tilt like a tow truck bed. In consoles it's kind of difficult. I could try. Who knows? Can you show 50 feet gooseneck pulling a 50 feet bumper trailer? Actually, I don't know if I can because I haven't scripted yet. The rear hitch of the bumper puller, but let me do it very fast. Let me close the game very fast, and let me do it very fast. I believe the hitch ain't there, so far I can't actually do it. But since this is here, I believe I can add here a hitch. Hold on, the damn music of Farming Simulator is just driving me nuts. So far, I just need a transform. Just need this and add it where? Frame extras rear bumper here. Okay. Let's name it rear attacher joint, and that's gonna be a new attacher joint for it. And now you're gonna see a trick. Since the positioning of the joints editor is just confusing. I do something that people that it's starting to mod is gonna love. Because I create a cube. And when I create a cube, I just place the cube inside the transform to see where the transform is actually. So then I make the cube small. And then I drag the attacher to see where is it. So there it is. There it goes. And let the cube be a little bit bigger to kinda, okay. You see that it really helps to see where the things are. Small cube placed here and there, and it helps you like figuring out what are you doing in the 3D world. Okay, nice and easy. Now, as far as I can remember, it should be looking backwards. So, oh, the ranchero, not the ranchero. I don't want the ranchero. So it needs to add a double attacher to the back. Hold on, need to... I have it somewhere. Oh yeah, on my big techs. I have it on my big techs. It is coming to consoles. We have 400 people. I mean, we've been here 2 hours. And on my mind, I'd imagine that everyone was already in bed. But you still there, waiting and listen to me talking nonsense. And that's just awesome. So, I need not an attachable, but an attacher. Where do I have my attacher? Here, an attacher joined. So, it's gonna be just like that. It's gonna be universal, trailer hitch assembly, this one. I need this one, and I need to put it in here. I believe I don't have any attachers declared. No, I don't. I have the attachable, but not the attacher. Okay. I know I'm talking nonsense. Just stay still. You're gonna understand what I'm doing right now. Attacher join configuration. I don't need the name for that. But it's not called attacher join, but it's called attacher something. How do I call it? Rear attacher join. That's the thing. Let me include it. Hold on. I am the best. Look, I'm not. Make the fuel run out at a realistic speed on the TLX. You know, you might like it, but there is going to be a lot of people that don't like it. So that's why this kind of stuff is kind of tricky. If there was an option to select or deselect the real fuel consumption ratio, I would add it. But it's not there so far. Where are my attachers? So that's rear attacher join, then that's rear attacher join. Trailer low, everything's fine. And now I need to check on my gooseneck trailer. Because on my gooseneck trailer, I have the attacher somewhere. Tail options, rear attacher. And it's the, you see the difference? That's PC only. And level of detail on this thing is just insane. Even the springs in here are awesome. I mean, it took me a while to build this one, but it's quite a thing. So rotate Y is 90. So that's why rotate Y needs to be 90. Pointing backwards, save it. Minimize, go into the game. So, you were saying, hold on, because the lights weren't working either. And it was because of the rotation of them. I script them poorly. So I'd said, working light L, this is the rotation, start and end rotation. And I believe that's just so messed up. That's so wrong. Hold on, I'll be paying attention to the chat in a second. Just need to hold on a bit, okay? So that's frame front. Where are my lights? That's front lights, front shell lights. No, actually, this is on the attacher. That's working light L. So that is 000. And what I wanted to do is that. Okay, so starting rotation, that's 000. And then the rotation should be like that. So probably 0 minus 80, 0. Okay. So let's see if it fixed. It's pit modding on the live stream. Could you make a copy of the track that changed the fuel consumption rate? Again, it's that'll be weird. I could make the trailer, the truck, hold less fuel. But the thing is that these options wouldn't be so common. Wouldn't be so loved. There would be, you can imagine, a lot of people complaining about the fuel consumption on the trailer, on the truck, sorry. And I don't want it. I don't want it. I want people to be happy with the trailer, not to be upset with the trailer. So what I was doing, oh yeah. So, okay, we said triaxle. We said this is going to be flat deck. That's going to be 50, and that'll be all. Okay, now we're going to do a bumper pull. Okay. And now we're going to grab... Well, I have my monster in here, you see? These are the kind of stuff I need to fix. The overlapping in the store. There we go. So, why would you do that? I know who would do that. He's gonna have fun with this, but why would you do that? Why am I changing the day night? No. Why would you need that? It's about 42 feet. Yeah, you're a lunatic. No, the hitch is not compatible with the ramps. CW, the 50 gooseneck is about 40, in between 40-42 feet if you set up the ramps. Without the ramps, it'll be probably 36. Hauling hay or straw from a field. Working light on the bumper pull. Okay, I'll do it. I mean, it doesn't take long. I can add them just to be there. Just to be there. The thing is that the rear hitch on this thing, it's meant to be used with all the trailers. Not even the camera is able to show the road train. Well, as I was saying at the beginning, the options are there for you. Can I make the gooseneck tilt like a tow truck bed if it's possible? Not right now. That'll release. That will require a lot of rebuilding thing. Side extensions for the oversized load. No, there is going to be a trailer for wide loads. This truck cannot be on consoles. Just let's do that again. I did it before. I'm going to do that again. Okay. That's a mod thought, imagined, and designed for consoles. You see the complexity on it? It's looking very good, but it's not complex. Okay? Now look at my truck. You can't see through it. It's very complex. So, not possible. And yeah, it's a beast. It pulls everything like nothing. It's just amazing. Okay, what else? What else we have? If there is not something else like worth to add, you don't ever want to know what DJ would do here. You will know it soon enough. Would a hay bed on a truck be possible for consoles? You're gonna have it. Logistic Brands is one of the sites. Okay, we have TLX, we have 82's Logistics, and we have 82's Tools. You haven't seen that yet, but there is 391 people now around the world that are going to be aware that 82's Logistics is going to be completed by a ramification or a side brand called 82's Tools. That's going to be awesome. What about a normal box for the TLX? Not right now. I'm considering it, but not right now. Seed trailer and fertilizers. You're not gonna need them. You'll have the TLX. Outer load. Again. Okay, let's do something. I'm gonna try to talk with 4D modding. Famous 4D modding. I'm gonna try to talk to him to see if he is willing to help me out with the auto load, because he did it and he did it perfectly. If he is willing to help, I might be able to add it in the future, not right now. But if I can get like help from someone like that, I'm not gonna risk the quality of the mod issues and stuff because of that. What else? Oh, for PC, AJ Grand, the man in here. So yeah, it's gonna be awesome also in PC. I mean, it's gonna be a very, very used truck. I would like to think. When is DJ reviewing this? Need to agree on that. But before that, I need to polish it. Because, well, DJ does an awesome work breaking stuff, so I'd rather be prepared. There was someone before in the stream, someone that was asking about the lights on the trailer. Are you still there? If you're still there, just pay attention. Okay. Okay, lights are now working as they should. What else? Mac on Monday. Hi there. Lights on the bumper pool. Actually, there is a bunch of lights. Now they are red. They are going to be like properly coated yellow, but there is lights everywhere. What else? No, the rims are gonna be as is. The rims are gonna be like realistic trailer rims. Not gonna add fancy rims or such. I believe these ones look awesome, and that'll be all. Jesse, there is not going to be a regular bed for the TLX so far. Not now. Who knows what happened in the future. Michael Monday, you know the answer for that. Okay, guys, we've been here 2 hours. Road tires. There is the standard tires that comes with the game. You can set them in there, but... That's huge. I mean, that is huge. It's looking very good, I'd say. Oh, this one is flipped. Yay. Need to fix that. Okay, what else, guys? Color of the lights. Not gonna happen. What about a flatbed trailer that can hold a 40? That'll be tricky to build. Not right now. I mean, I'd rather get you the trailer and then experiment, that just hold it and experiment and you'll never have it. No, it's not a track for that. 82's Logistics semi truck. Wow, that doesn't sound bad. Who knows? Two bars on the neck. No. Two bucks on the trailer. No. Perfect, Michael Monday. You should show your progress somewhere. Okay, guys. Talking about 82's logistics and stuff. So, let me just make this very easy for you. That was the purpose of this stream. I would love to know your opinion. I'd say it's been very good. Still, there is 368 people connected to the stream, which is awesome. If you're there and you haven't hit the like button or the subscribe button, it takes nothing to you to do so, and to me means like a lot. So imagine that you are playing, I don't know, an instrument, piano, and you go to a concert, and when you finish, no one claps your hands, no one claps his hands, you would feel bad. The like button in the YouTube, the subscribe button on the YouTube, it kind of represents that. It kind of represents people expressing that whatever I did, it's of your liking. So I really, really appreciate when you do this small movement with your finger and you like the stream, or when you subscribe to the channel and follow the news and etc. It really, really means a lot. So thank you all for being there. Remember, you have access to the Facebook page. You can also follow the Facebook page. With the release of the TLX, I'm going to be opening a group for you all to share, post, get together, get ideas, gather ideas, build ideas. And finally, let's see if some of these ideas are going to happen or not. Thank you all for your attention, guys. Love you all. Thank you, DJ Goham, for the publicity, for sharing my stream. Thank you, FS Club, for doing the same. Thank you both. Thank you both for the support that you're giving me. I mean, I wouldn't be here, and that's a fact. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't because of FS Club, because of Expendables modding, because of custom modding, and because, of course, DJ Goham. So thank you all. Thank you all. And of course, last but not least, thank you guys, because you support them, you support me, and you make us grow. And as we grow, we grow in our options, mods, etc. Thank you. Thank you guys, and have a nice evening. See you tomorrow, hopefully. with the newly release of the TLX 2020. Remember, if it does not happen tomorrow, it will happen Wednesday, but it's going to happen. See you guys and have a nice one.